what about making yours sound better?
Hi there, and welcome to the next section of Music Theory from the Top, which is intervals and chords. So, let's start with intervals. The first thing that we need to know about an interval is we've already learned two of them, and one is the semitone and the tone, or the half step and the whole step. So an interval is just the distance between two notes. So we can have any distance in music and it will have a name, and it's important to know what name and what quality. So let's just define two words first, which is the type, which is basically the number of distances away. So I'll just put number for now. And then the quality. And the quality is major, minor, perfect, augmented, or diminished. You might have heard some of these words before. But if not, don't worry. So, let's take a really simple example. C to G. Now, let's count up how many notes that is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is, the type is a fifth of some sort. Now, all fifths can either be perfect, augmented, or diminished. And this, at 7 semitones away, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, is a perfect fifth. It's a very strong, very stable sound. It's what your power chords on guitars are made out of, and it's what a lot of music is based off. And we can move those two notes anywhere. As long as there's 7 semitones in between, it can be between any two notes. Now, if we do the same thing, but this time we make the interval a little bit smaller by a semitone, we get a diminished fifth. Which is kind of your standard spooky dissonant sound. Now, think of diminishing. If you diminish something, if your food supplies diminish, they get smaller. So as the interval of a perfect fifth gets smaller, it becomes diminished. Now, if it goes the other way, if it becomes bigger, which is from going from a perfect fifth to bigger, then it becomes augmented. If your food supplies, for example, are augmented, they're made bigger. So perfect, diminished, and augmented. So perfect, diminished, augmented applies to fifths, fourths, and octaves. And also unisons, which is the same note, but we won't worry too much about them. So we can have a perfect fourth, 1, 2, 3, 4, perfect fourth, a diminished fourth. We can also have an augmented fourth. And then we can have a perfect fifth, a diminished fifth, an augmented fifth. And we can also have a perfect octave, a diminished octave, and an augmented octave. Now, you might have noticed that some of those are very similar or exactly the same as each other. So, for example, an augmented fourth is the same as a diminished fifth. So, fifth diminished is the same as a fourth getting augmented. But what's the difference? So, It's how we spell it. This is where the sharps and the flats become really important. So, C to an F. That's a perfect fourth. One, two, three, four. If we make that F sharp, we've stretched our interval a little bit. It's become bigger. It's become augmented. If we do the opposite, if we go from C to G, but we make G smaller, we've squashed our interval. Remember, F sharp and G flat are the same note. So that's exactly the same, but they're spelt differently. One is an augmented fourth, C to F sharp, and one is a diminished fifth, C to G flat. This will be important when we start writing chords and building chords, but for now, just know that there's the same thing, just called two different things. Then the next examples are every other interval. So we have C to E, which is a major third. And anything four semitones away is a major third. Now we can make that a minor third by flattening it. And if we were to flatten it again, we'd then get a diminished third because it becomes even smaller. And that would have to use a special symbol of a double flat. But that's very rare, which means E, flat, and then flat again. Even though it's a D, it's called E double flat if it's a diminished third, but they're very, very rare. And then we can also have a major third, and we can have, so this is a major third, E, C to E natural, and we can have C to E sharp, which is an augmented third, E, and then E sharp, which is the same as a perfect fourth, but as we mentioned here, the spelling really matters, because this C to E tells us it's some type of third, and the quality is then augmented. So, we can make a nice little chart, which shows that we have diminished, minor, major, and augmented, like this. And then we can put perfect here. And basically we can go between any of the different areas of the intervals by going up or down a semitone. So perfect down a semitone goes to diminished. Perfect up a semitone goes up to augmented. Augmented down a semitone goes down to major or down to perfect. Remember, perfect intervals can only be fourths, fifths, and octaves. So if they're not fourths, fifths, or octaves, they're one of these. So let's take a second, which are two notes apart. That's just a normal major second because it's in the major scale. Now let's make it minor. How would we make this minor? We'd have to lower one of them by we'd have to make the interval smaller. So we could either bring this one up or we could bring this one down. Let's bring the D down to a D flat. That's now a minor second, also known as the semitone that we've been using. Let's go back to our major second. And let's make it augmented. Now that is also the same as a minor third, but spelt differently. So C to D, some type of second, and it's an augmented second. If we had a different perfect interval, then we'd skip major and minor and just go perfect, dim, perfect, augmented. So these are intervals. We now understand intervals. What's next are chords, and how do we build chords? So let's take our C major scale. And then what we do is we take numbers 1, 3, and 5, like we did for the arpeggio. And all we do is we play them all at the same time. So instead of one after another, we play them together, which gives us a C major chord. We've started on C and we've used 1, 3, and 5. Now, remembering how to make a minor scale from the major scale, we flatten the 3, the 6, and the 7. To make this a minor chord, all we'd have to do is flatten the 3rd. So we go from having a major chord to having a minor chord, which works nicely. Now, so those are the two most common chords, major and minor chords, and they're they're used for most of music, but there are 3 other types of chords which are worth mentioning. The first is a diminished chord, which is a minor chord (1 flat 3 5), but also what we do to it is we flatten the 5. So we bring this G down. So it goes from a minor chord to diminished, which is a very common, scary sound. Again, we're talking very basically here about scary, happy, sad, but it's good to get these sounds in your head. And then the other type is we make a major chord, which is 1, 3, 5. And then we sharpen the top note. So it goes from being a major chord, and this is an augmented chord. So this has 1 natural 3, and it has a sharp 5. And then finally, this type is used a lot in kind of classic rock music and in a lot of dance music as well, which is a suspended chord. And there's actually 2 types. There's this type, which is a sus2 chord, and then there's this, which is a sus4 chord. So the sus2 chord and the sus4 chord. And these have a really open, airy quality to them. So the sus2 chord is called because if you get suspended from school, you get taken out. So the 3rd has been suspended. So we've taken out this 3rd, any type of 3rd, a minor 3rd or major 3rd, we've taken them out, and then we've put a 2nd in instead, which is nice. And then the same for the sus4 chord as well. We've put in the 4th instead, which often then goes to the 3rd to resolve onto it. So once we have those chords under our belt, so we have major, minor, diminished, major, and then we have augmented, then what we can do is we can move on as well to so once we've discussed those 4 chords, then all that's left to say is that you can use them pretty much as you wish. But let's just do one more example, starting from a different note other than C, so that we understand the construction. Let's take D. So we remember that we have to create a D major chord. So do we remember in D major we have F sharp and C sharp? So we have, that's our major chord. Now, if we lower the F sharp, we get an F natural, which gives us our minor chord. Then we can make a diminished chord by then lowering the A. And going the other way, from our major chord, if we sharpen the A, we get an augmented chord. And again, we can make sus chords as well. So as long as you know what your major scale is, what key you're in, so you know what sharps and flats are there, and you know the degrees of the scale, so this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, then you can use these formulas listed here to pretty much just pick and choose from any key and put in the make the chord that you want, which is really, really handy. In the next segment, we're then going to look at what chords go in what key and progressions in general and putting it all together.